morning, everyone. Welcome. This is always a great occasion and the calendar, the yearly calendar. And I'm very, very sorry to start with some terrible news. We learned last night that we lost our retired registrar, Milton Clement. Milton passed away. It was very suddenly, and as I understand it, there aren't many details, and of course, we'll publish them as they become available. But Milton has been retired now some years, and just terrible, terrible news. So I apologize for starting out on a sad note. If we could, please, let's take a moment of silence for Milton. Thank you. I did want to make an announcement also to our retirees. We'll be recognizing them in a second. But after the breakfast, our Office of Communications has asked that the retirees, all retirees who are here, if you would meet in the lobby. We're going to form 50, a human 50 of retirees. Does that make sense? And out in the lobby for a photo, okay? Be a great photo op. And so let's get started. We have a full agenda. I wanted to also introduce our Board of Trustees Chair, Joseph Marshall. Joseph Marshall, there he is. Do you want to speak anything? And I would like to ask that she stand, if she would. We are honored with the presence of our President Emerita, Eileen Farley. Eileen, would you stand? Would you remain standing, Eileen, for a second? And thank you. Eileen Farley, ladies and gentlemen. Second president of Bristol Community College, 1978 to 2000. And while President Farley is standing, I would like to ask all retirees if they would stand also so we can recognize all retirees. Thank you for your service to the college. Thank you, everyone. And we need to thank, of course, Chef Carissimo and our culinary arts students. Everybody have enough to eat? There's still more. Okay, they always do a fabulous job. So now I would like to announce, begin announcing the Service Recognition Awards. And I'm very proud. You know, people, as you know, I'm going to be retiring here in the following next year. But one of the things I'm most proud of is the recognition memorials that we have provided, the commemorations, if you will, of the services for the various levels of employees to the college. And remember the old days, we used to have trees and flowering bushes, and I never understood how we decided what goes where. But we are now, I hope you've had a chance to see outside of the art gallery, in the garden outside of the art gallery area, the sculptures. And the sculptures stand, symbolize the various service levels, 5, 10, and so forth. And the names are inscribed there. So I think that's a wonderful way to recognize the service that people have done. And some of you, this might be a place to mention, some of you have asked about part-time recognition, and I'm very glad to say that Tafa Awolaju is putting together a group to discuss the best ways that we can include part-timers in recognizing them. As you might know, you might imagine there are some, you know, they have some issues to deal with about what constitutes a year, 1 year of service, so many part-time years or whatever it is. It may be, so they're going to deal with those questions. And I charged them to have something ready in place for next year at this breakfast. So we'll be able to also honor our part-time adjunct faculty as well as part-time employees. So let's move ahead as we honor the Service Recognition Awards. Embodying stages of garden life, the sculptures have a planter base with the names mentioned on the plaques, as I mentioned, for employees who have reached the service milestones. The sculptures are a sprout and a blossom and a flower and leaves for 30 years, fruit for 35 years, seed for 40 years. So if you haven't had a chance, it's very attractive, let alone useful, memorial that we have outside of the art gallery. So I would like to start, if all of the five-year employees would please come to the front of the stage, right here, everyone in 5 years.
They're in the program?
Yeah. Yep. 5 years. 5 years service to the college. Seems like only yesterday, right? If you could stand in alphabetical order, that would be better.
They're going to have to take a picture.
Yeah.
How does Laura pronounce her last name?
Laura Akinyemi. Laura? Lara, come please upstairs. Just Lara. She's the best one of all of you. Yeah, thank you. Okay. Rebecca Benyer Soderbaum, come on up. Rebecca Soderbaum, let's hear it for her.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much. No, they do. Okay.
Angela Buffy. Not here. Melissa Carberry. Melissa.
Angela's not here.
Nikki Kalar. Nikki? Shelly Costa. Amanda Donovan. Amanda.
Amanda, 5 years already.
I know, it's crazy. Thank you very much. Thank you so much.
Marianne Laguilla, dear. Marianne.
Yeah.
Yeah, good. Looking good.
Yeah. Marianne, congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Right over there.
Okay.
Melissa Mello. Melissa. Shelley Murphy, Michelle Shelley Murphy.
Five years already? Shelley, 5 years.
Holly Pappas.
Thank you.
Linda Roberts. Yeah, Linda can join us. Avarilla Santana. Patricia Shriver. Thank you, Patricia. Martha Ucci. Martha Ucci, 5 years. And last but not least, Alice Wilson.
Keep trying.
BCC?
Yes. Oh, yeah.
Alice, congratulations. Thank you, Alice.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a group photo of the five-year employees. Could you recognize this group for 5 years of service to Bristol Community College? Will the 10-year service people please come forward in the front of the stage? 10 years of service. Alphabetical order. Jim, you go to the head of the line, right? Oh, no, Carmen. Carmen. 10 years of service, Carmen Aguiar. James Armstrong. Jim? Lynn Byers. Lynn Byers. Lynn Byers. 5 years, 10 years of service. Sorry. James Zima. James. 10 years of service. Anne Marie Gomes. Anne Marie. 10 years. Eileen Harrington. Eileen Harrington. 10 years. Kathleen Mello. Kathleen, 10 years. Mock the men. Mock the men. Jennifer Wyszerski. Jennifer. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for 10 years of service, a group picture. Service at Bristol Community College. Okay, 15 years, 15 years of service. Rodney Clark. Oh, could you come forward? Sorry, I'll give you time. As we get up in service, we have to spend more time gathering. Wait for you, Keith, wait for you to get here. Wait for you to make it all the way up. He's swung out. 15 years of service, Rodney Clark. Rodney Clark. Not here today. Bernadette Driscoll. Bernadette. 15 years.
Bernie, congratulations.
Syl Ferreira, Professor Syl Ferreira.
Yeah. Congratulations, Syl.
Syl, thank you. I think it becomes
that. Rhonda Gabovich. Rhonda Gabovich. Years of data she's bringing with her.
Thank you, Ron.
John Malloy. John? There he is.
John, congratulations.
Jess Mayhew, Jessica, 15 years. Justin McCann. Justin, 15 years.
Justin, so proud of you, buddy. Thank you.
15
years.
Yeah.
Yes,
sir.
All right. Ken Novo. Ken.
Ken, congratulations.
Thank you, my friend.
Felicia Pacheco. Earlier. Brian Pirate. Brian. Elizabeth Santana. Keith Tebow. One more, Jack Sprega. Where'd he come from? Yeah. 15 years. Everybody's been saying how time flies, and to me, it isn't. I can't believe it. It seems like 40 years, you know. 15 years of service for our group. How about a hand for them? Years of service, would you please come forward? Come up on the stage. 20 years. Somebody need the ramp instead of the stairs. Huh? Yeah. Come on up to the stage. Please come forward. Okay. No, no, just...
That's not over here.
How do you know? I'm just flying by, eh? Okay, we're going to recognize 20 years, Carlos Pereira. Carlos. Lucy Resendi. Lucy, yeah. Lucy, congratulations. Colleen Vickery, we want to recognize. Colleen, Division 5. Patricia Weisberger. Patricia. Yeah,
congratulations.
Yeah. Yes. Nancy Lee Wood. Nancy Lee Wood.
Congratulations.
Okay. 25 years of service. Would you please come up on the stage? 25 years. Everything okay?
I saw Karen Costa. Oh, she's coming.
Yeah.
The only one.
Oh, but Joanne Clancy? Is she a nurse?
No. No, that and I see that.
Joanne Clancy, 25 years. Please recognize her service. And Karen Costa, We'll get a picture. 30 years of service. I should have called this earlier to give him more time to get up here. Would you come up on the stage, please? Years of service.
Who's helping who?
Who's helping who up the ramp there? Okay. 30 years. Sally Cameron. Sally Cameron. Chef John Carissimo. John.
Congratulations, my friend. You did a great job.
Pam Chadwick. Pam.
Congratulations, my friend. Thank you.
And Kathy Torpy Garganta. Kathy
Torpy Garganta. Congratulations.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, let's recognize 30 years of service, Bristol Community College. Okay, you ready? Oh, did I finish that? Should we finish that picture? Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Just right.
Now it's our honor to recognize, it's our privilege to recognize and honor our retirees. And we start with a video, okay? We have a video.
Describe BCC in one word.
BCC, in one word, is my life. It is the place where I have learned so many different things, become a different person, become a fuller and happier person in so many ways, and I just think that it's just forever woven into my internal being, and I will never forget everything that has happened here.
One word to describe Sue would be dedication. Sue was very, very dedicated, and she had a job with a lot of responsibilities, and she took them seriously, and she would do whatever it needed to get a payroll done, so very dedicated.
Well, I would describe BCC actually in two words: student success. Many of our faculty give everything that they have to help our students succeed, and many of the students come back and let us know how much they appreciate it, and had it not been for their faculty, they would never have succeeded and reached their goals.
It gives me great pleasure to talk about my friend and colleague, Fred Marshall. Fred Marshall was a hard-working maintainer. He take very good care of his building and have a great rapport with the people he served.
Nancy was very committed, whether it was her college service that she did, and she spent much time on the CWCC committee, the curriculum committee. She was an astute nurse educator and was committed to that level of programming and course instruction, or whether it was her innovative teaching style that she had. Nancy will always be remembered for walking down the corridors with her Jeopardy board game, teaching about the cardiac cycle and how perfusion rules, and it is the one thing that nurses should remember.
Yeah, my word to describe BCC is a word that's been used a lot, and it's the word community. I see us as a community of educators, administrators, support staff, the custodial staff, and we all work individually towards this common goal of making BCC the wonderful platform that it is to help students achieve their goals of education and career.
If I could describe Bobby in one word, it would be, that's tough because there's a lot of words. Dedicated. She really, you know, was dedicated to her work, and she was really focused and wanted to have everything in order. And even like speaking with her about her family, she was very dedicated to making sure that they had times to really spend together and with her friends to keep up with them. She still had, when her former co-workers that had retired, and she knew that they were in town, they would get together for lunches, and so she was very dedicated to her friends and family and to her job.
If I could describe Bobby in one word, it would be friend. I mean, I've known Bobby for a long time, and she's taught me a lot, maybe not necessarily job related, but I'm a better person because of Bobby.
The one word, which is opportunity. A great opportunity for students that come in that may have additional needs, whether it's a disability, a language difference, whether it is someone that through the beginning of their education did not really get all of the basics that they should have. There's a great opportunity for those people to continue and to rebuild, you know, the basics within themselves.
One word to describe BCC is a very difficult charge. So I will say the only word that would really describe BCC is community. Community.
What I will always remember about the college and my colleagues, certainly the people in college communications and TV services, are just the most fun to work with. We have more fun than is legal, and we laugh a lot, and we produce fabulous work, and this is the wand with which I help see that happen.
Well, with Sue, there are many memorable things that stick in my mind, but if I had to pinpoint just one, I would say it was her sense of humor. Sue had a really, really unique and funny sense of humor, and even in some of the most stressful situations, she can make you laugh at something. I really will miss her great sense of humor.
I'm going to miss the many people that I've met over these 35 years. I have so many great memories, and they are like a second family to me.
Fred never missed the opportunity to fix himself a plate after an event in G Building, because Fred always get his job done early to enjoy his coffee break.
Well, I spent 16 years working with Nancy, pretty much of that time close, side by side, in companion roles. We were both clin specs, and we had similar nursing education philosophies, and many times we were put into situations where we were working together on projects or experiences. But I met Nancy the first day I arrived at Bristol Community College. I was not a new nurse educator, nor was she. She was already in a two-room office, and there was no space for a third person or an office space set up. So Nancy just pushed aside her books, looked me square in the eye, and said, "Well, welcome to BCC. You're welcome to the corner of my desk." And I think that welcoming spirit is what I will really always remember. I wish her so much love and light in her retirement.
I'm going to miss the feeling of contributing and making a difference. What truly goes on at BCC is learning. In the financial aid office, we've given millions of dollars to help students and support them while they achieve their goal. I'll also miss working side by side with all the competent, good people that make, again, BCC what it is.
The most memorable thing about Bobby would be the gorilla. What happened was, it was Bobby's 50th birthday, and Jessica hired a gorilla to visit the party.
To dance for Bobby. Well, it was a telegram singing gorilla. It was actually me and Terry Correa that used to work in the bursar's office.
And the people she hired, the gorilla, thought Bobby was a male. So this gorilla showed up.
In a bikini.
Trench coat and a bikini. And I've never seen Bobby laugh or turn a shade of red like that ever.
I don't know
before
if
or since.
She was laughing or she was humiliated. We had a ball. It was the funniest thing that ever happened. And she had to sit there while this gorilla was dancing for her birthday. And it was hilarious. We talk about it. I mean, it's been almost
15 years.
15 years.
And we still talk about it.
We still talk about it. It was like the best party fiscal ever threw.
The people that you work with, right? There are a lot of wonderful people here. The interaction with students in a variety of situations. It's always the people side of things that you miss. I'll miss a lot of the people that are here. There are a number of people that have already retired. I miss them as well. And a number of students that were really outstanding.
My favorite part of the job is working with students, which I do almost exclusively as their director, as their teacher, as their advisor, as their mentor, and many, many times as their friend, eventually. The light that goes on in their lives is one of the great gifts of my life.
Well, you see the emotion and the terms that run through all of those videos about dedication and commitment and the love for BCC and our BCC family, commitment to our mission, the wonderful things that we do. I hope that when you see the emotional experience, that you've just witnessed, that it reinforces for you the value of all that we do at BCC, and it's beyond one individual. The value is a collective. The whole is greater than the sum of its parts, And it's just a privilege when you see from the service awards how long people stay here because it's a fabulous place and it's a place for people to grow professionally and to fulfill the wonderful, I always call it a noble mission that we have at BCC. So my thanks to each of the retirees. We're going to call them up individually as well. And we'll begin with Rylan Brenner, if he would please join me on the stage. Rylan was only supposed to have one word. He said community twice, but I guess. After 30 years of teaching at BCC, Bren is retiring the end of this spring semester. Bren came to BCC with an MFA from Brown in creative writing. He came in 1986 and founded the BCC Theater Rep. During his time at BCC, he produced over 100 theater productions and supervised another 50 student-run productions. Bren, thank you for all that you've done at BCC and your many years of service and all that you've taught our students. We're very grateful to you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Please say a few words. I'll hold on.
Well, I don't have a lot to say. I just want to say in my work is the support and the gift of so many others, is the work of so many others, and if I start thanking people, I will forget a lot of people. I'm proud to say that we entertained many thousands of children with our 10 years of children's shows. And I am gifted because I worked under the guidance and support of two visionary presidents here, President Eileen Farley, who brought me here, and President Jack Sprague, who kept me here. And so many colleagues who have helped to populate our stages with themselves and their students. And all I can say is if you missed our theater, you missed the work of great students and the passion of great students, and you should not miss the future, because I have to say our students are the gift. They're the unsung heroes, and they are what made our work, especially my work, tremendous. So thank you very much.
Rylan Brenner, ladies and gentlemen. Would Sally Cameron, please join me on the stage. Sally. Sally came to BCC after working as the Director of Communications and Public Relations at Barrington College and Director of Publications at Evangelistic Association of New England and press coordinator for the Saratoga Performing Arts Center. During her years at BCC, Sally won many awards for her creativity and was recognized as BCC as Employee of the Month with a Silver Shield and was inducted into the Scepter and Scroll Society. Sally received a Bachelor's in Arts, degree in journalism at Northeastern and a Master of Arts in Professional Writing from the University of Massachusetts, Dartmouth, and will retire this summer after 31 years of dedicated service to BCC. Sally Cameron, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for all your service.
Thank you. 31 years ago, I was having a little bit of agita because the college where my husband and I were working was closing, but I had the best job search of my life, 9 applications, 7 interviews, 4 job offers. And I was waiting on my dream job at Northeastern University as the editor of their alumni paper, my alma mater, and there was a job posting in the newspaper, in the Providence Journal, about Director of Public Relations at Bristol Community College. And I said, well, you know, I'm going to do it. I'm going to apply because it's practice. You know, the more interviews you get, the better. And I went through the interview expecting my dream job was where I was going to be. And much to my surprise, this became my dream. And I came here thanks to Eileen Farley and Richard Sobel, who took a chance on me from a Christian college, which is where I was from, and whether I was really going to be able to work at this heathen place. And there are so many people. I'm the last of the first institutional advancement team that was hired here. And I remember those times so wonderfully, fondly, to build an operation that has now become the College Communications Office and is just such a gift to work there every day. So the first thing I learned here at Bristol Community College was that don't let your dreams get in the way of what's really the best for you. Another thing I have learned is that life is short, and we've already mourned the loss of our friend Milton Clement, who did so many wonderful things for me in finding students of color, making sure we were communicating with students of color effectively. Cindy Jansen, who was my first admin and was just a hoot and so smart. And so now I'm retiring because life is short, and I am grateful for the opportunity that I had to be here and to do things that I think are pretty wonderful. But I'm also so grateful that I had a community like this one where I could raise my son, where I could mourn my husband, and I could make wonderful friends that will be with me forever. Thank you so much for letting me tell your stories, and thank you for so much for creating the stories that I could tell. And thank you for changing the world, learner by learner.
The next retiree, Sue Sestodio, is unable to join us today, but I did want to read her blurb about this retirement. Sue was a student at BCC, receiving her degree in business management and marketing. As an employee, Sue started full-time at BCC in 1987. She began her BCC career as a bookkeeper one and retired last February as an accountant four. And so we want to thank Sue Sestodio for her years of service. Sue Sestodio, ladies and gentlemen. Phyllis Dickens, Professor Phyllis Dickens, can you join me? There she is. After working as personnel manager for Filene's and in management training at Cherry and Webb, Phyllis became a part-time instructor at BCC in 1983 and a full-time instructor in 1994. The owner of Bellwing Turkey Farms, Phyllis earned a Bachelor of Science degree in industrial management and an MBA from the University of Rhode Island. She retires at the end of this spring semester. Phyllis, thank you for all of your service.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You get a picture, Phyllis, and then have you say something. Or... there we go. Okay.
Unlike what Ryan had to say, where he had only a few words that he wanted to mention, I really have a few words I want to mention
very few, okay. Mostly I just want to thank everyone for many, many years, many hours of tremendous support, more so towards the end as I seem to lose it more often as far as all the computer operations, and the people that are in that division know, so I'd call them often. But I thank you all, and I can only tell you it's been a great privilege to be here and to see all the great things this college does. And I know everyone that's here now will continue with the remarkable work you do. It's a great place, and enjoy it. Thank you.
Phyllis Dickens, ladies and gentlemen. Unable to join us today is Professor Nancy Evans. Nancy Evans. Nancy came to BCC in 1998 for full-time instructor after having received nursing degrees from the University of Rhode Island and Boston University College of Nursing, and worked as a clinical educator at CCRI, URI, and St. Joseph's Hospital School of Nursing. Nancy also served as department chair of nursing in 2010 through 2011, and retired in January after having attained the rank of professor. Nancy Evans, ladies and gentlemen. Unable to join us also is Bobby Gonville. Bobby came to BCC as a full-time employee in 1988 after having been a student majoring in accounting. She started as a bookkeeper one and retired in April as an accountant three in the accounts payable department. Bobby Gonville, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your service. Fred Marshall, unable to join us today. Alfred Marshall, we call him Fred. Fred came to BCC as a part-time employee and quickly joined the full-time ranks in 1988. Fred was a vehicle operator dispatcher in the United States Air Force and a Vietnam veteran. He retired in January of this year after more than 27 years of service to the college. Fred Marshall, ladies and gentlemen. Joanne Petrassa, I believe, is unable to join us today. After coming to BCC as a CETA worker, Joanne became a full-time employee in 1982, working for many years in the records department. She was a general studies student at BCC and received a certificate in floral design. Joanne moved to Division I in 2003 and retired as an administrative secretary in that division last January. Joanne Petrassa, ladies and gentlemen. Roland Sullivan. Roland, there she is. I don't know if there was any spare change in the financial aid office we could use. Roland first started at BCC in 1971 as a part-time junior clerk and typist, and worked her way up to Associate Director of Financial Aid, from which she retired at the end of February, last February. She is a graduate of BCC and received her bachelor's and master's from the University of Massachusetts, Dartmouth. Roland was a recipient of the Commonwealth Citation of Outstanding Performance in 2000. Roland, thank you for all your years of service. Roland Sullivan, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, I didn't come prepared with any remarks, but I started here in 1969, and through all of that, I've made so many friends, and driving in this morning and walking in the building is such a warm feeling. I've really enjoyed working with all of you. This is a great place, and thank you very much.
We need to get a picture around that Kevin.
Thank you, yeah.
Lalonde Sullivan, ladies and gentlemen. And now we are going to recognize our professors emeriti, Deb Lawton and Barry McKee. Will Deb Lawton and Penny Hahn please join me on stage? And I will ask Penny to say some introductory words.
Penny?
Yeah. And both. Oh, you can ad lib too.
Oh, no ad lib. I'm reading the citation for Debbie. Deborah Lawton, Professor Emerita of English. Educator, author, and student champion, you committed your entire career to student success, exhibited in each of the many roles you took on at the college. Your creative approach engaged us in appreciation of and commitment to the arts, languages, and culture, and through your generous and gentle manner, called us all to value their role in our lives. June 4th, 2016.
It's like an Olympic medal. Thank you very much, Penny. And thank you to Division I and the Professor Emeritus Committee and to President Sprague. I'm deeply honored to receive this award. It means a great deal to me to be included among those faculty previously recognized with that title. I didn't get here alone. To quote the next president of the United States, sorry, Joe, it takes a village. And for me, that village includes the BCC community and my own family. Many faculty and staff encouraged, challenged, supported me in the various positions I held here, and they set examples for me to follow. You know, it's so nice coming back here as a retiree every year, and I see some of those colleagues and friends who mentored me, opened doors for new opportunities, stood by me whether I succeeded or failed. You know, I see President Farley, Dave Feeney, Penny Hahn, of course, and so many others I can't name. I was fortunate to work with the accomplished faculty and staff in Division I, and I've begun and ended my career in the English department. And I know everyone thinks their own department's the best, but that's a group who model every day how to be caring and skillful educators. And in between, I saw life at a college from a different perspective, through the eyes of the dedicated professional staff and academic administrators who work so hard all year round on behalf of our students. But the center of all those models for me have been the students, those who demonstrated a love of learning and a dedication that was inspiring to me. And then those whose personal accomplishments might have been less celebrated, but they were no less important to them personally and to those of us who notice those. Most of all, I want to thank my family, my husband Kevin, and my daughter Amy, who are with me today and every day. I have to do a little shout out to them. Amy's going to be receiving her master's in library science this month. and I'll be celebrating 45 years of marriage with my husband, Kevin, this fall. They are both going to heaven. So thank you all very, very much for this great honor.
Glad you're glad. I'm going to get a picture, I think.
Deborah Lawton, ladies and gentlemen. It gets emotional all morning, doesn't it? And unfortunately, our next recipient, Professor Emeritus Barry McKee, is unable to join us. He'll be with us at commencement, however. He has asked, and I have asked, Professor Alan Rolfe to come forward and read the citation on behalf of Barry McKee. Alan?
Thank you.
We will present the medallion to Barry at commencement.
Thanks, Alan. Thanks for doing this.
Barry did very much want to be here. He couldn't, but he will be here at commencement. Barry McKee, Professor Emeritus of Criminal Justice, practitioner and consummate professional, you further strengthened a rigorous program with robust standards and curricula that continually evolved to ensure that students are career ready. You demanded the very best from your students and your colleagues, modeling the highest levels of expertise, integrity, and community service for those who would serve the public good. Barry McKee, June 4th, 2016. As I look out, I can see that a lot of people don't know Barry. Barry was a professor here for 25 years. He was the coordinator of the criminal justice program for over 20 years. He was a recipient of the Scepter and Scroll Award. He was honored to deliver the last lecture at commencement. He was one of the first members of the staff and faculty senate, and he was one of the first ones to develop online courses at Bristol Community College. So Barry's left a large footprint here at BCC. And he was also a unique individual. He would wear sandals throughout the winter, usually without socks. He bought a home in Florida on a golf course, and he does not golf. But knowing him as I do, I'm sure that the one part of the citation that is most meaningful to him are the words, quote, "You demanded the very best from your students." And I think I can speak for Barry and say that this is the highest praise that he could receive from his colleagues here at BCC. And before he left, he instructed me. He didn't ask me. He instructed me to, quote, keep the standards high in the criminal justice program. And whenever I talk to him on the telephone or via email, he always ends the conversation with, keep the standards high. And I will definitely try to do that. Barry did that for 25 years. He demanded a lot from his students. But Barry also gave back as much as he gave to his students. And that's why I'm privileged to accept this on his behalf, and I'm privileged to call him my friend. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, you can see the emotion involved all morning, really. I want to say that the success of the people that we've honored, 5 years of service all the way through professors emerita, I think demonstrate the value of BCC, all that we do, and their success that you've seen represents our collective success at the college. And our BCC family is just incomparable. There's no one better, and it's really an honor and a privilege to serve our students and to serve the community. Remember, community is our middle name. If I was going to be Brent, I'd say it twice. Community, community, right? So I hope you all take pride in the accomplishments, not only of the people we honored today, but every day, and all the people that we have in our BCC family. And now to recognize some more wonderful people, I'd like to call Kathleen Burns to the stage to present the Honors Award. Kathleen Burns.
Kathleen, okay, buddy.
Good morning. I'm Kathleen Burns. I'm the chairperson of the 2016 College Awards Committee. The first award that I'm presenting this morning is the Silver Shield Award. The Silver Shield is awarded to members of the college community who have made significant contributions to the college community above and beyond the duties and responsibilities of their job description. This year's Silver Shield recipients are Donna Ayala, recipient is Sue Bassano. Congratulations. Next recipient, Beverly Derry. I don't know. I guess she's not here this morning. The next one is Melissa Damaris. Melissa Damaris. The next recipient, Doreen Gardner.
At the end, call attention to that over there as a group. Yeah.
Doreen, congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you.
Congratulations, Doreen Gardner. The next Silver Shield recipient, Esteban Martinez.
Congratulations, my friend.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Esteban Martinez. The next recipient is Livia Newbert. It is a long walk. Congratulations, Livia Newbert. The next recipient is Patrick Stone. Congratulations, Patrick. Patrick Stone. The next recipient, Keith Tebow. Congratulations, Keith Tebow. Okay. The next Silver Shield recipient, Linda Viveras. Congratulations, Linda Viveras. The last recipient of the Silver Shield Award this year is Patricia Weisberger. Congratulations, Pat Weisberger. And once again, congratulations to all the Silver Shield Award recipients. I will now present our most prestigious award, the Scepter and Scroll. Membership into the Scepter and Scroll Society is given to members of the college community who consistently provide exceptional college-wide service and or leadership above and beyond the duties and responsibilities of their job description and over a period of years. Recipients are installed in perpetuity into the Scepter and Scroll Society. This year's recipients are, first one is Rose Farrow. Rose Farrow. The second recipient is Paul Jefferson. Jefferson. And the last recipient of the scepter and scroll is Sharon Perrow. Congratulations, Sharon Perrow. And please again congratulate our Scepter and Scroll Award winners. Thank you. Thank you.
So, can we have one last recognition for a Silver Shield and Scepter and Scroll Award? Great service to the college. Well, I think that's the end of our program. I want to remind the retirees to meet out in the lobby. Sally will arrange you in a 5-0 to celebrate our 50th. But before we go, I'd like to once again ask President Emerita Eileen Farley to stand, if she would. Thank you. Stay standing, and we'll. I have said every year how we stand on her shoulders and move forward, and it's absolutely true. And can we have, if Eileen, if you would stay standing, I would like to ask the new retirees, the brand new retirees, to join, also stand and join President Farley. Okay. And the all retirees, if you would stand and join. So we can honor your service to Bristol Community College. Thank you very much for all you have done for BCC.